One day I was riding in a cab and I got a cell phone call of an artist wanting me to see their work. I get many of these calls and it just, you know, usually say, well, send us something. But the artist's voice was so urgent at the time, and the project was when he started talking about communities doing a sewing project for the firemen, I became more interested. And then when I found out he was a few streets away, my partner and I, Caroline Kerrigan, rushed over there, and we were thrilled about just what happened when the door opened. I just knew it was a project that needed to be seen by the population now and as part of their healing process.
I've always been obsessed with firefighters since I was a kid. What's not to love about them? They're part of this unshakable brotherhood, and it's like being a member in a really cool gang or something. In the mid-1990s, a good friend of mine gave me a box of back issues of this magazine called With New York Firefighters, which was basically just a monthly magazine for firefighters. And he found it at a garage sale, and he knew that I was a painter and that I was always looking for new images to paint. And I painted from photographs, and he thought I would appreciate the photography in the magazine. I did a lot. The photos were breathtaking, dramatic images of men holding hoses and fighting these ruthless blazing fires, risking their lives. And I was totally fascinated by them. So I began painting a series of paintings based on these images. In September of 2001, I found myself living in a shell-shocked New York City. It was a really surreal time to be here. And that day was so traumatic for everyone, but to be a New Yorker and to witness in person what happened was really like devastating and life-changing in so many ways. So in the weeks that followed, many of my friends and neighbors, myself included, were all walking around in sort of a daze, and it was then that I felt a strong urge to start a public art project, or to start a project that gave my community a chance to come together and allow people to express their feelings and also make something special and memorial at the same time. My fire station on 13th Street, Ladder Company 3, lost 13 guys that day, and I walked by that station all the time, and it was heart-wrenching to walk by the station in the aftermath. I got the idea of using my older artwork, the fireman paintings that I had done years before, as a way to create a new piece of art that would somehow recognize these heroes. And I took three of the paintings and I made stencils of the images and went to Mood Fabric Store and bought like every color of felt that I could find, and tons of thread and sewing needles. And I started cutting these silhouettes of firemen out and sewing patches. The first one I made came out really cool and had such a therapeutic effect on me that I decided to make more. And the more I made, the better I felt. The more I did it, the more the idea came into focus that I wanted to invite, you know, friends over and neighbors and have sewing circles as a way to talk and keep busy and create something during this really insane time in New York. At first, it was just friends coming together to sew patches and talk about feelings and gossip and work through some of the stress and the anger and confusion that we were all feeling.
Everybody feels like they want to do something, you know, and I haven't like felt like I felt like I wanted to help, but I didn't know how.
Friends of mine that I live with upstate took some patches. Basically, anybody that came over and saw what we were doing was like, "Can I make one?" You know, and pretty much they leave with five patches.
Eventually, the more patches we made, the more the project kind of came into focus for me, and I decided that I wanted to make this into a 343. Hand-sewn patch memorial. In October of 2001, we had a show out in Williamsburg. We put all the patches up in a small gallery, and across the street we had a night of music and just a night of remembrance, and it was a really, really great, really great night. After the Williamsburg show, Margaret Bodell got involved and she really went to bat for the project to be shown in Manhattan and also helped me get some press, just get all hands out there.
Of all the things being done artistically, this one's great because it brings in a lot of people to work on it. It's not just one artist's vision.
I feel like there was a lot of room for individual expression, you know, in your stitching, like just in what color thread you chose to use. And what was powerful is seeing all 343 patches on the wall, and every single one of them was different, with different stitching, different colors, a different style, and that in itself is incredibly powerful, just to see the individual expression all come together into this one expression, which was great.
This is getting to be like a puzzle now. It's like, getting funky.
Also, just because it brings people together in that way. I think that you cannot not love it. When you touch it, it's soft. To look at it, it's beautiful. And the fact that he was working on fireman paintings 2 years ago, you know, that he knew the importance of their role in the community and was honoring them that way. And then this tragedy happened. And then, you know, he thought of a new way to go about it, using what he had been doing to react against what happened in a positive manner, and that's his brilliance.
It's really appreciated. I know I speak on behalf of everybody from the fire department that we want to thank everybody for all their contributions, all their love and sincerity, and showing and displaying all this is really beautiful and deeply appreciated.
It's just a documentation of how much there are people there to help us if anything happens. Like, clearly, just by showing these patches, shows the dedication of the people we have to protect us.
You know, there's not enough that you can say, but anything that you say is already been said. So, just, I don't know, it's a fucked up situation.
Well, the fire department has been getting recognition, you know, that we never had before. And, it's a lot, actually. It's hard to believe how much affection people are showing in this way and a lot of other ways. It's really great. I just wish it never happened, you know? I'd rather things be the way they were when no one really even paid attention to us.
Well, I think the artwork will help people remember how many guys died that day. You hear the number 343, but you know, if you see something that you can count them, you get an idea how many guys were lost.